Craig Nation asked if I would give a land acknowledgement, and I'm happy to do so. Before I begin, you'll notice I might look a little underdressed, but it's a hoodie I wear with pride. And if you look at the back, some of you might recognize it. I received this, and these are made by Greg during the first pandemic year, and I'm wearing it tonight just to say how wonderful it is to have live music again and listen to live music. And so, kind of honor of those who weren't able to perform live in the first year. I'm certainly honored to be wearing this. We're in for a great night of entertainment. But before we begin, since Russia invaded Ukraine and began the horrific acts of invasion, I've probably given the land acknowledgement maybe a dozen times. And it's always kind of bothered me a little bit because we give the land acknowledgement about what colonization did here. And you look at what's happening in Ukraine now, Russia, and it took us here several hundred years to realize what we did was wrong, what we did was cruel, what we did was genocide, and to begin the process of decolonization. And one can only hope and pray that it doesn't take Vladimir Putin that long to realize what he's doing is wrong. But what he has to do is stop. We're on Treaty 2 territory this evening on behalf of Brandon University. I welcome you to the lands of Dakota, the Anishinaabeg, the Cree, the OG Cree, the Dene, and the people of the Métis of the Red River. We're in for a good night of entertainment tonight. I will just have the pleasure of introducing Niall Axted Legare, the director of the Brandon University Big Band. Welcome, and have a great evening. Thank you.
by the great arranger Thad Jones. Thad, in the idiom of big band music, is one of the pioneers and kind of the most influential voices. And him and the drummer Mel Lewis had this band that ended up becoming the Village Vanguard Orchestra in New York. That was one of their arrangements, a really famous and a beautiful arrangement like that. We're going to kind of continue in that lineage. So the Vanguard Band still exists to this day, and one of its chief composers after Thad was a man called Jim McNeely. And Jim McNeely is still alive today, still writing, still performing. So this is going to be a pretty big deterrent or a big shift, in the evolution of big band music. So that last one featured McKenna Tenhouse on baritone saxophone and Dylan Pelcher on the trumpet. So we're going to move along with this composition by McNeely. This is called Skittish, and we're going to feature a lot of members of the rhythm section.
Thank you. Thank you.
Mr. Benjamin Kentroff on the tenor saxophone. All right, we've got one more for you. Thank you again. Before we do this last piece, I just want to introduce the band really quick. So on saxophones, we have Jacob Pfeiffer, William Powers, Nicholas Bray, Benjamin Kentzoff, Tegan Werner, and McKenna Tenhouse, our saxophone section. We have on trombones, Robert Meninges, Logan Enns, Faith Hollenbaum, and Connor Smith, our trombone section. On trumpets, we have Dylan Pelcher, Layla Christensen, Rebecca Taylor, and Alec Driver, our trumpet section. At the piano, we have Jeremy Littlefield. On the bass, we have Tylene Haywood and Janina McAllowad. On the drums, we have Esteban Sorarin. We have Andrew Morand, and we have Jacob Jubenville. And guitar, Dane Neufeld and Emmanuel Bach-America. Please give it up for the band. I also just want to say this has been my first year out at Brandon, and I just want to thank Dean Gation and all the faculty and staff at the school. It's been an amazing experience. I've been very honored. It's been a real pleasure to teach here. I also want to thank these amazing students. You know, I've thrown a lot of difficult music and a lot of expectations at them, and they've risen to meet it every time. So I just want to say thank you all for a great year and all your hard work. So we're going to end off our last tune. We're going to feature another big band composer, you have the Vanguard band that was Thad and Mel Lewis. At the same time, on Monday nights, you could also go to the Jazz Standard to hear the Mingus Big Band. And so we're going to feature our baritone saxophonist Tegan Werner here on this one. This is going to be Mingus's Monin, arranged by Cy Johnson. Hope you enjoy. Thank you.
So we're going to see how quickly we can get bands off and off, on and off stage tonight. My name is Greg Yashin. It's my pleasure and honor to serve as the Dean of Music here at Brandon University's renowned School of Music. We're so delighted to be able to be in this building. So while I'm sort of killing time as bands switch up, this building has become our like official home away from home. And so I won't risk last names, but the School of Music has worked really closely with Terry and PJ and Amy and Tom. They've become friends and colleagues through this past year and have opened up their doors for our ensembles. So we're thrilled to be able to have one last 21-22 concert here in their building with our large ensemble. So can we thank the staff here at the West End? The group that is assembling behind me, as you can probably clearly see in your programs, is called the Eclecticos. No, I think it's just called Eclecticos. It's under the direction of someone who's not quite as new to our community as Niall, but someone who is new to our community and fairly recently graduated from the School of Music with a master's degree in performance and literature. I'm standing right behind me. He's a beautiful guitarist, a wizard with technology, and a truly first-rate music educator. My friend and colleague, Jogo Peixoto, and Eclecticos. Thank you. hope to see. And first of all, thanks everyone for coming. It's obviously a joy to be able to play music. Again, for people, I cannot tell you how excited me and all these guys are. This is the highlight of our semester every year. It's like, okay, now we're playing. So thanks everyone. So that was Lovely City by, this was recorded in that famous album, Birth of the Cool. And this was arranged by Gil Evans, which is a great arrangement, music by Miles Davis, and that featured, and before I say who that featured, my students know that I struggle a lot with memorizing the names, so I promised that they were gonna laugh today because I'm gonna pronounce them wrong on purpose, of course. But I wrote on my phone, so at the end of the concert, hopefully I'll get all of it right. But that one featured Jeremy Yu, did I get that right? So, hand for Jeremy. And Keegan Agamadorian, did I get that right?
A little wrong, Agamadorian.
Agamadorian. Keegan Agamadorian. Awesome. So the next tune, it's called Tio Macaco, and that means in Portuguese, Uncle Monkey. And for that tune, I'm gonna need a favor from you. You figure out what that is right now. Just give me a second. Yes. Okay. So I'm gonna be playing the triangles with this tune. And when I told my students, they kind of laughed. I'm like, you're gonna play a triangle? What do you do with that? Like, well, that's actually very traditional in Brazilian music. So I'm gonna play the triangle. I'm gonna try. And I'm gonna need you to clap with the band.
Jeremy Allen, Jeremy Hugh, and Emmanuel Smith, Mika Molson a little bit, and, don't say it. Don't say it. Oh, where's my phone? And piano solo. I'm sorry, to be honest, we were live streaming this and I was just running. I'm sweating, not because of this, because I was running trying to find the right cable to make the sound work for live streaming, so my brain kind of foggy right now. But I'll get all the names right at the end. Okay, so the next tune, we're gonna do a mashup. So this tune that we just played is by Snarky Puppy. And the next tune, we're gonna do a mashup. And between two tunes, one tune I'm sure you're gonna know it, so I'm not gonna say, hopefully you know what that is. And then we'll go straight to another tune called Back Kids to the Back, which is also a Snarky Puppy tune. I hope you enjoy it, and let's do it. Guitar or guitar him? What's your last name? Bidart. It's almost. Derek, I'm sorry. I've been doing this all tour. Sometimes I forget my own name, and I'm not kidding. It's true. My name is Joe, but my mom sometimes calls me Diego. So you see where the plot problem started. No life. Okay, let's do it. Thank you. Hopefully you got the one. And back into the back. So very quick now with my phone. On the saxophones, but one at a time, okay? But you find all the ones, because I might get lost. Keegan Agnadorian, Lauren Chimansky, Kaylee Carlson, Ashton DeGroot, on the flute, but kind of in the saxophone section. And guests today, Jeremy Allen, Carlin MacFarlane, Jenny U, that L hard, and Austin Benaboo. Big hand for the saxophone here. Back here on the brasses, those guys are doing a miracle, and four people playing all of those lines. So Emily Penny, Morgan Parmore, Connor Smith. Yeah, I have two Smiths here. And Emily Riding. Big hand for those guys. I'm actually not reading. That's so weird. Okay, now I'm going to read. Maybe not. On the rhythm section, we have a big rhythm section here. So pianist Jeremy Littleford. It's always you. I mean, it's me, but it's Derek Bedard. Mitchell Mosen, Jazz Jensen, Emmanuel Smith, Anu Rangotra. I got it. At least one. Logan Dick and Josh Getter. That's the one that I got. So that's the rhythm section. So thanks a lot, all of you. Thanks a lot, all of you. Thanks for putting up with me trying to remember your names. Thanks for your patience. And congratulations, you did a great job. A big hand for this band. Thank you so much.
I would like to thank Jogo first for making me look good with remembering names, and more importantly, of course, for doing such a wonderful job directing me in Mexico. So, another round of applause for Jogo, for Jogo, and the technical ensemble. I'm sure, checked your programs and are aware that the next group that's coming out is the symphonic band. So while we wait for this colossal ensemble to take the stage, I would like to first thank all of you for coming out to hear these three ensembles tonight. We have another three ensembles playing tomorrow night. Hopefully you'll be able to come back and hear our concert choir, our university chorale, and the Brandeis University Orchestra. I do know that some of you have traveled quite significant distances to be with us here tonight, so your support of these tremendous young musicians is, it's not just that we notice it, we really appreciate it. And as at one time or another, for some of us, a very long time ago, we were in very similar situations, so we're so well aware of how much your support means to their development and to our school and university, so thank you so much for being here tonight, and maybe we should give you a round of applause. And they're gathering in behind me. An event like this, in any time of year, during any conditions, requires a lot of work, teamwork, frankly, and we really have a tremendous team here in the School of Music. The reputation of our School of Music is well earned by the folks who came before us, and people who are here now are really an extraordinary collection. So the team in the music office, Bobby White, Joyce Burba, and Terry McMaster, they're tremendous. None of this would be possible without their work, so thank them. And our large ensemble directors, this is their idea, and it's their organization, and their tremendous work ethic and dedication to providing students with a great experience. So I'd like to thank our large ensembles as a team for, I think at one point, weekly meetings to pull this off. So Dr. Andre Dagenet, Dr. Leanne Zacharias, whose ensemble is here tomorrow night, and then the wonderful directors that you heard tonight, Niall Baxter-Lagari, Joko Pachoto, who are doing this work as part-time faculty members. So they're on their spare time they're taking time to help us organize the plan. And then Dr. Wendy McCollum, who is behind me, as you can see, moving stands and chairs. So I would like to thank the team of colleagues who put this together. And then I think what I will do now is I'll introduce the symphonic band and then sneak off the stage, put my mask back on, and go join you in the audience to hear them. But the symphonic band is, I believe, our largest ensemble. And you'll hear students from all programs and all years. So our first year students through fifth year music ed students, although they probably are student teaching right now. So it's a really wonderful ensemble, great training ground for future music educators, and under the direction of our internationally renowned symphonic band director and instrumental music educator, I'm going to put the microphone down on the podium for you, Dr. McCollum. And so you need help moving stuff. You're good? Okay. So I will wait for them to finish up, turn the microphone over to Dr. McCollum. Wish you all the best for a lovely remainder of your evening, and hope to see you back here soon.
he's Andrew McCollum, the conductor of the symphonic band. We're going to tune in. Before we do, we're excited this evening to present to you a piece that is the world premiere, which was composed by Pete Meakin. And I have a message here called Note to Read Out. It says, if Wendy is reading this to you, it's because I'm not here. This is from our composer. Please, someone ring 911, as she actually has me captive, and I'm just hoping she'll read this out in public. Sadly, the real reason I'm not there is not as action-packed as that, nor was it because I was worried someone would be inspired by Will Smith whilst I was introducing the piece. No, the real reason is that there is COVID in my household, and whilst I don't have it myself, I think this is a time where being on the side of caution is probably the way to keep everyone in our communities as safe as possible. Somewhat ironically, this is a piece that has its roots in the pandemic. In late March 2020, Robert Ambrose, director of bands at Georgia State, brought together 12 composers and arrangers to produce music that was fully flexible, meaning music that could be played no matter what the circumstances may be, as at that early stage of the pandemic, no one knew where we'd be able to make music together again, and when we were able to was still unknown as to how many of us would be able to be in a room together at a time to make music. Taking the Fifth, our first composition, was written as a part of this project, but in my mind, I would score it for full band just as soon as I could. The piece itself was inspired by so much of the news at the time. Whether it was the pandemic or the craziness of Donald Trump, it felt like every time I heard something, I would find myself saying that this really tastes the biscuit. The predominant interval in the piece is a fifth, and given that actually rhymes with the original non-biscuit word that I would use instead of taking the biscuit, especially as, at the time, all of Trump's allies were busy taking the Fifth Amendment, the U.S. constitutional right to not incriminate yourself. I'm truly sad to not be there tonight. This is the world premiere, and given that I'm not there, it means that all of you have heard the piece before me. Thank you to Wendy and the group for all of their hard work in preparing this, and for being part of commissioning Taking the Fifth. Stay safe and be well. Love and peace. Pete Meakin. our stage tonight. We're very fortunate to this semester have had interaction and master classes online when needed to be with a couple of folks, one of them being Dr. Pete Meekin, who you heard as the composer of the first work, who talked to our students about the composition process and the idea of the artist's life during the pandemic and the importance of grit, and also, you know, answered some questions about the composition world and working as a professional freelancing musician in the composer's view. And second, we are have been working on this piece of music by Frank Prosciutto called Summer in Central Park. And we are featuring this evening a professor who has just retired from the University of Toronto, who taught first public school music education in Manitoba before studying in jazz studies and moving on to be a pioneer jazz education at St. FX, and also then to move on to McGill and the University of Toronto. Will you please welcome to the stage Gordon Hoyt.
Good evening, everyone. It's a real pleasure and an honor to be here. It's certainly not my first time at Brandon University, and there are many people here who I've known and worked with over quite a few decades, actually, including your dean, Greg Gation, great guy, great saxophone player. Glad to know you, Greg, and glad to see you. And thanks for calling me Santa. And of course, Dr. McCollum, I've known her when she was a Xander. Yeah. So, and I met her here actually at the Brandon Jazz Festival. What year was that?
It was the
91. Yeah. anyway, Wendy wanted to invite me out to play at least something. And so my undergrad and first graduate work was at the University of Minnesota. And Frank Prosciutto was the director of bands there at the University of Minnesota. And he saw my work as a teacher at Silver Heights in Winnipeg. And he thought, hey, this would be good, get you back to the University of Minnesota, direct some bands, and be my graduate assistant. So that's what I did, and so I had the honor and privilege and pleasure of playing in his the top wind ensemble there from University of Minnesota as an undergrad, as a clarinet player, and as a graduate, as a saxophone player. So it was a real pleasure to work with him. This piece was done in 1996, and it was done a year after what I think of as one of his really fine works, which I hope this band will do at some point. It's called Symphonic Jazz Suite. And he wrote it for himself, a wonderful alto player, and Clark Terry. Those of you who are brass players will know the wonderful flugelhorn trumpet player, Clark Terry. And so when I heard this, I thought, oh, this is really exactly a takeoff of the Symphonic Jazz Suite. So it's kind of a compressed version. Anyway, I won't take any more time and we'll get to some music, but thanks again for inviting me, and it's a pleasure to see you, whom I've met and know from the past, and to make new acquaintances, and look forward to more. Thanks, Woody.
to our percussion section, who have been so flexible in learning and preparing instrument parts for a large collection of repertoire. And I also would like to say that we decided this evening to close the concert with a concert band standard, the first suite in E-flat, which is in three movements, and it's by Gustav Holst. It was written in 1909, which is a long time ago. It's a special year for me because it was the year that instant coffee was invented. And we've all had those times. Maybe it was in a hotel room or at a campsite when instant coffee has saved the world. Or at least it seems like it. A lot has changed since 1909, but this work remains a standard. It's a beautiful piece of music that is played around the world. And we have a bit of a bookend, British bookend today. Dr. Meakin, Pete Meakin, of course, is from England, and this piece was also composed in England and was originally performed by bands in that country, although it's become a standard. I would like to just say one final thank you to our dean who was on stage here. Without his planning and his efforts and his sort of vision into what the students needed and what faculty needed over the course of the last 2 years, everything from microphones and microphones and cameras to practice room fobs and masks and teaching resources and just time, creative thinking on so many levels, we really couldn't do it. And I know that the students on stage are so thankful for him, and he's quick to give out the thank yous to our faculty and students, but we're not quite as quick to say thank you to him. So can you please join me in giving a round of applause? But I want to say that the students sound beautiful on this in very many unique conditions. This is the first time we've used this seating arrangement is today for dress rehearsal and performance, because normally we're 7 feet apart and spaced and wearing playing masks. So it's only for pedagogical purposes that we're doing this evening. And I want to thank the students for their quick adjustments and their patience as we all try to figure things out. And it's only made them stronger and quicker thinking. And as they proceed to the world, through the world in this next month, just remembering the wonderful evening that we were able to have here with the people that are live streaming, as well as the people that are here in the audience. So please, please stay safe over the next months and join us in celebrating these students on our final number, First Suite in E-flat by Gustav Holst.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, everyone, for joining us this evening. We are so glad you were here and also hopeful that you can join us for the concerts tomorrow evening. If you have confirmed tickets, that's tomorrow night at 7:30 for the orchestra and the choir. If you didn't have tickets and you wanted to join us online, you can either go to Facebook or to the YouTube School of Music channel and watch that online as well. Thank you so much. Please travel safely and keep safe. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. We really appreciate you joining us.